I guess for a zoo, when we're dealing with animals that are living, you know, really into the later stages of their life, we like to do regular, what we refer to as aged animal assessments. So we want to make sure that the health and well-being of our animals is optimised all the way through their life. And that includes actually three elements, really: their physical health, their mental health, and their behavioural health. And so this geriatric health exam is just one component of that. So we're focusing in this particular instance on his physical health, and then we'll combine that in an assessment with all his other care staff, and we'll evaluate his well-being in total. So this is one component of a bigger assessment. For a Siamang, their expected longevity or expected lifespan is around about 40-ish years old. So any animal that hits their early to mid to late 30s will come up and have a geriatric health exam done on a regular basis. And I guess for different species, the regularity and the nature of the exam might differ. And so what we're basically wanting to do is do a comprehensive assessment of their physical health, and that's really important as animals age. As when people age, some of our body systems start to degenerate, and I guess in terms of we want to do a comprehensive examination from head to toe, and in a species like a Siamang, that's quite challenging to do with them awake. We can get quite close to them for visual inspections, but some elements of the examination that are quite important, both for their own well-being and also for our safety, it's best that they're conducted under a general anaesthetic. We want to do a dental assessment. We want to check their skin, their eyes, their ears. We usually conduct a blood test, and again, it depends on the species as to what we're specifically looking for, but things like kidney function, liver function, any evidence of cancers, particularly with older animals and those that are quite active, we want to look at joint health, body condition, whether they're at the optimal weight and body condition. And then it's also an opportunity for us to give them any vaccination boosters that they're due, and we also screen them for infectious diseases. And in primates, it's important that that includes some of the infections that can affect humans as well. Sudara's health check went really well. He was a perfect patient on the day, and his recovery was very smooth. We were very pleased to find that all of his joints in particular were excellent health for his age. Siamangs move through their exhibit or in the wild through the forests via a system called brachiation, and you probably see them swinging around in the trees. So particularly their shoulders, elbows and wrists, the health of those joints is really critical, and in his case, you know, they looked fabulous for his age. He had good dental health. He did require a little bit of a dental clean, so that was done. He was due for his tetanus booster vaccination, so that was given. We didn't find any evidence of any infectious diseases, so that was wonderful as well. And a couple of minor changes we identified on his blood work and on one of his x-rays that'll just help us tweak his care moving forward, and also will allow us to monitor that closely in his follow-up geriatric health exams in coming years.